Nucleosynthesis. The structure of the glass has been altered at the atomic level.
Problem with the replicator?
Unlikely. A problem with the replicator would have affected the contents as well as the glass. But the liquid in the glass was a synthahol replication of a light ale of Earth origin, which is, I believe, what Lieutenant Duffy ordered.
Well, I can't detect any residual radiation or any unusual chemical compounds that would have caused this.
The most probable explanation is that the glass came into contact with an unshielded power source.
That means a complete diagnostic check of the Enterprise power systems, all 4,000 of them.
Do I have the perfect man for the job? Hey, Reg, you busy?
I was just, no, not really. What?
Got another mystery for you. Somehow, the molecular structure of this cup from 10 forward has been altered. We need to run through the power systems to see if there's a leak that caused this.
I was going to do that.
You were?
Yes, to try to explain the anti-grav unit failure. I still can't. Nothing about it makes sense.
Then it is possible that these two very disparate incidents could be related.
I wouldn't bother you with something that's minor, Commander, but it may be a symptom of a more serious problem.
Do you think we'll need to put into a starbase?
We'll have a better idea after Mr. Barclay runs a check on the power systems.
It was Lieutenant Barclay who first suggested a link between the two incidents.
What? No, it wasn't. I mean, not really.
Will your investigation affect our available power during the mission?
No. No, sir. We'll have to shut off some systems. We'll shut them down a few at a time. It shouldn't, I don't think so.
Good. I look forward to your report, Mr. Broccoli. Barclay.
If you will excuse me.
Metathesis is one of the most common of pronunciation errors, sir. A reversal of vowel and consonant. Bark to Brock.
Yes, I know him. He comes in, he stands at the bar. He doesn't say much. He orders a warm milk.
Figures.
Warm milk helps you sleep, LaForge. You should try it. What's this have to do with Barclay?
I don't know. I'm just trying to figure the man out. Do you ever talk to him?
He doesn't talk much.
Does he have any friends?
Not that I've seen.
What do you do with a guy like that?
Well, I just serve him warm milk and let him be.
Yeah, well, I'm not so lucky. I can't let him be. He's my problem.
Well, he's imaginative.
How do you know that?
I know.
Well, then maybe he's in the wrong line of work.
You engineering types don't appreciate imagination.
That's not it, Guinan. He just doesn't fit in here.
Turcum.
What?
Reminds me of Turcum, my mother's brother. Sort of the family misfit. Everybody told me to stay away from him. Bad influence.
Did you?
Are you kidding? He's the only member of my family who had a sense of humor. Except no one ever stayed around him long enough to realize it but me. My mother tells me I remind her of him, and I probably do. The idea of fitting in just repels me.
Maybe I'm not making myself clear, Guinan. Barclay, well, he's always late. The man's nervous. Nobody wants to be around this guy.
If I felt that nobody wanted to be around me, I'd probably be late and nervous too.
Guinan, that's not the point.
Are you sure? Excuse me.
Lots of beans. lots of beans, oh beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, yeah.
I love beans, diggity doo.